Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. Not long ago, we posted two charging reviews and one teardown of the UGREEN multi-port charging stations. You can click the upright corner to check that. And we've also tested its charging performance before taking apart. So today, let's see how this UGREEN 200W 6-in-1 desktop charger performs. Firstly, let's briefly introduce this desktop charger. It has 4 USB-C ports and 2 USB-A ports on the front, and there is a 3-prong socket on the back. There are 4 rubber pads on the corners, and the specs info is in the middle, modulus CD271. It can support inputs of 120V, 50Hz, 2.5A, the USB-C 1C2 can support up to 100W, and the USB-C 3C4 supports up to 65W. The USB-A 1A2 only supports up to 22.5W. It has passed UKCA certifications. The size of this charger is about 101 by 101 by 33 mm, so the power density is about 0.59 W³/cm, and the weight is about 515 g. Chargelet Power ZKM00-C shows the USB-C 1 supports SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, QC5, and PBS protocols, and it also supports 5 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and videos of USB-C 2 are the same as USB-C 1, so both can support up to 100W. The USB-C 3 supports all protocols of USB-C 1C2 and has an additional FCP. And the videos for USB-C 3C4 are slightly different, which is just 20V, 3.25A, instead of 5A. The supported protocols and PDO info of USB-C 4 are also the same as USB-C 3. And then the USB-A 1 supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0 protocols. USB-A 2 is the same as USB-A 1. And it comes with a thick power cord with a 3-prong UK plug for grounding. Length is about 2 meters. In addition, there is a dual USB-C cable with a woven design, and the length is about 1 meter. Chargelet Power ZKM00-C shows is a USB 2.0 cable and supports 20V 5A. Next, let's go ahead and take a look at its charging compatibility. Since USB-C 1 and USB-C 2 are exactly the same, we'll just test C1. It can trigger the 20V for this 16-inch MacBook Pro 2021, and the power is around 94W. It can also fast charge the Red Magic with PPS, and the power is 54W. And since the USB-C 3 and USB-C 4 are also exactly the same, we'll just test C3. It can still trigger the 20V for this MacBook Pro, but the power is reduced to 65W. It can fast charge the Red Magic with PPS, and the power remains at 54W. Therefore, USB-C 1C2 should be mainly used to charge laptops, while USB-C 3C4 is used to charge mobile phones. The USB-A 1 can provide 20W for the Huawei phone. Since there are 6 ports for this charger, we'll put the ports usage and power distribution guideline on the official website in the video for you to compare. Firstly, let's use it to charge 2 devices. When using the first 2 USB-C ports, the power can be divided into 100W and 94W. When using USB-C 1 and USB-C 3, the power can be divided into 94W and 65W. And when using USB-C 3 and USB-C 4, the power can be divided into 65W and 65W. Next, let's add in the USB-A 1 A2 port. When using USB-C 1 and USB-A 1, the power can be divided into 94W and 21W. When using USB-C 3 and USB-A 1, the power can be divided into 60W and 21W. And when using both USB-A, the power can be divided into 10W and 10W. Then let's use it to charge 3 devices. When using the first 3 USB-C ports, the power can be divided into 61W, 66W, and 50W. And let's add in the USB-A 1 A2 port. When using USB-C 1, USB-C 2, and USB-A 1, the power can be divided into 61W, 66W, and 21W. When using USB-C 1, USB-A 1, and USB-A 2, the power can be divided into 94W, 10W, and 10W. When using USB-C 3, USB-C 4, and USB-A 1, the power can be divided into 65W, 65W, and 21W. And when using USB-C 3, USB-A 1 and USB-A 2, the power can be divided into 65 watts, 10 watts and 10 watts. Next, let's use it to charge 4 devices. When using all USB-C ports, the power can be divided into 60 watts, 45 watts, 46 watts and 18 watts. So the actual power of USB-C 2 is only 45 watts instead of the 65 watts on the guideline. Just like the previous tests, add in the USB-A 1 A2 port. When using the first three USB-C ports and USB-A 1, the power can be divided into 60 watts, 56 watts, 46 watts and 21 watts. And when using USB-C 3, USB-C 4, USB-A 1 and USB-A 2, the power can be divided into 63 watts, 52 watts, 10 watts and 10 watts. Finally, when using all ports at the same time, the power can be divided into 65 watts, 40 watts, 35 watts, 20 watts, 10 watts and 7 watts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro 2021. The voltage is always around 20 volts. The charging curve can be divided into three parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 90 watts for the first 48 minutes. Then the power gradually dropped to 72 watts, 47 watts in turn in the second part. The final part begins at 1 hour and 50 minutes, and the power slowly dropped to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 3 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The charger can charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro to 44% in half an hour, and it can reach 79% in an hour, 100% in 2 hours and 3 minutes. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts 50 Hz is 0.228 watts, and 0.044 watts at 110 volts 60 Hz, which is about 2 and 0.39 kWh in 1 year, respectively. And this is excellent in all of our standby power tests. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 78.38% to 91.7% at 220 volts 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 79.43% to 90.23% at 110 volts 60 Hz. Besides 5 volts 3 amp, the average efficiency can basically reach 90%, which is excellent among the desktop chargers we have tested. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Well, the data might look a little weird, but let's continue. Firstly, let's check out its ripple with no load. When the output is 5 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 32 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is in these 7 states, the lowest ripple is 60 millivolts peak to peak. Then move to the ripple when loaded. When the output is in these 12 states, the highest ripple is 32 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 20 volts 5 amp at 220 volts 50 Hz, the lowest ripple is 60 millivolts peak to peak. And then we'll put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour with full load. Starting with 220 volts 50 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front is 50.5 degrees Celsius, then the maximum temperature on the back is 51.8 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts 60 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front is 51.7 degrees Celsius, and the maximum temperature on the back is 53.3 degrees Celsius. Its maximum temperature is even lower than the much weaker 65 watts charging station mentioned at the beginning. Well, that's all tests we made for this UGREEN 200W 6-in-1 desktop charger. It has two USB-A ports for better compatibility and four USB-C ports that can support almost all mainstream fast charging protocols. And its total power can indeed live up to the 200 watts when charging with multiple ports. It also has nice efficiency, ripple, and excellent temperature performance. So it can handle most people's charging needs and replace other slower chargers on our desktop. Okay, that's all for today's video. And don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!